Hey, my name is Kaylee, and in this lesson, we're going to learn about how heat affects matter. Make sure you know the basics of matter by watching the video, What is Matter? Let's get started. Every gas, fluid, and solid thing is made up of matter. And matter is made up of tiny particles called atoms and molecules. Matter can exist in different states. You may have already studied some of these states. We will focus this lesson on the three most common states of matter: solid, liquid, and gas. This simulation is from CK12. We can see how matter acts differently as a solid, liquid, and gas. The solids hold their shape and volume when moved to a new container of a different shape and size. The liquid flows. It changes shape to fit the new container, but the amount of space it takes up, or the volume, stays the same. The gas acts much differently. Once the lid is lifted, the gas particles move to take up as much space as possible. Some molecules don't even make it into the new container. Gases don't keep their shape or volume when moved to a new container. Solids act the way they do because the atoms and molecules that make up their matter are tightly packed together, usually in a pattern, and they hardly move. They may vibrate or jiggle, but for the most part, they are fixed in place. That is why it is so hard to compress or squish a solid. Liquids are able to flow and change their shape because the atoms and molecules are not fixed. They're able to slide past each other, and they move faster than particles in a solid. The particles in a liquid have more free space between them than in a solid. This makes it easier for a liquid to flow and change shapes. But since the particles are still close together, a liquid is hard to compress or make smaller. Gases are able to change their shape and their volume because the atoms and molecules can move freely. Particles in a gas can vibrate, but they also move at really high speeds. There's a lot of free space between gas particles, and that's why it's easy to compress a gas. We can change the state the matter is in. This is called a transition. Recall that there are four main transitions. Melting, which happens when heat is applied to a solid and it transitions to a liquid. Freezing, which happens when a very cold temperature is applied to a liquid and it transitions to a solid. Evaporation happens when heat is applied to a liquid and it transitions to a gas. And condensation happens when cold temperatures are applied to a gas and it transitions to a liquid. Do you notice anything about all four of these transitions? Every transition is caused by a change in temperature, and a change in temperature is what we refer to as a change in thermal energy. If you've watched our videos on energy, you may know that energy cannot be created or destroyed. So when atoms and molecules have increased thermal energy, they move faster. This is called an energy transfer. But to what kind of energy? Kinetic energy, the energy of motion. Let's head over to a FET game to see what effects thermal and kinetic energy have on the states of matter. So here we are in the FET sim called States of Matter Basics, and we're in the second game called Phase Changes. And you'll see we have four different atoms and molecules that we can choose from. And there's also this handy phase diagram that we will use. I'll show you how to read it. We can change the temperature here. We have a thermometer here that's either in Celsius or Kelvin. We'll use Celsius because we're going to use water, and we will know some of those temperature points. There's also a pressure gauge here, so that's our compressibility with this finger. We can push the lid up or down. And we also have a pump here that you can add by lifting it up and bringing it back down, more molecules into your container. All right, so let's get started and see what happens with water. I'm just going to point out here with Celsius, the freezing point is zero. So that would mean the water will be a solid. And as you can see here, wherever the red line is, that is what phase we are in. So this black dot will be when our solid turns to a liquid, and up here, our liquid into a gas. So here we see our red dot is still on the solid point. So as you can see, our water molecules are vibrating and jiggling, but for the most part, maintaining their shape. So let's increase the temperature here. See, I can lift it up and then bring it back down. And then if I bring it back to that zero point, it holds it steady. So now I'm at 1 degree Celsius. At 0 degrees is the transition between solid and liquid. So you can see now that our molecules are moving a little bit faster and they're kind of spreading out, right? They're taking up the shape here. And what happens now if I bring the temperature down? Look at these molecules, how they're moving. If I bring the lever down, let's say to negative 80 degrees Celsius, what happened to the speed that my molecules are moving with? It's less now. See, they're just kind of barely vibrating. So let's add some heat again. So I'm increasing my thermal energy. I made it 13 degrees Celsius. Now you see they're moving a little bit faster. They've spread out into the shape more of how a liquid would look. Now let's add some more and see how their kinetic energy, so how fast they're moving, changes. So now I'm up here at 96 degrees Celsius. So now they're moving pretty fast. You'll see some of them are even getting an extra boost because they're moving so fast. They're spinning, and you see how they have a little bit more freedom. They can slide past each other. But right now I'm still as a liquid, just some of them are getting an extra boost. Let's see what happens as we compress our liquid water. So if I go down to kind of the beginning of where they are, you'll see my pressure is going up. What happened to my temperature? My temperature is also increasing. So that's because as this pressure goes up, the temperature increases, and my little molecules are moving even faster now. So let's relieve our pressure on our liquid water. So I'll see my pressure gauge is going back down. But these guys are still moving pretty fast, right? My temperature was increased from that. Let's add some more thermal energy. So I'm turning up the temperature here. You see what's happening to my molecules. Are they moving faster or slower? Yeah, faster. They're moving crazy and they're taking up a lot more space. And looking over at my phase diagram graph over here, it looks like I'm just now hitting the gas phase. So I'm right at that transition point. And you'll see these guys are moving freely. There's much more space between them. Now what happens if I try to compress my water molecules as a gas? So my temperature increased, my pressure increased, the speed of my molecules increased. And take it down a little more. Wow, I got some really hot temps in here. My pressure is going up, but look at how I can increase the pressure. I can compress my water molecules, but my pressure gauge is kind of bouncing back and forth, but it's overall getting lower because as a gas, I can compress it even more because there's space in here between these particles. Good, and let's lift this back up. So now you get a chance to play around with this. You can use all four of the different ones. They all have different transition point temperatures, and you get to explore what they look like in their different states. You've learned so much science in this lesson. Keep exploring the states of matters with our game and activities, and have fun, and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.